Good morning and welcome to worship at St. Barnabas on this beautiful Central Coast autumnal morning. Today we're celebrating All Saints and All Souls. If you're joining us on Facebook Live, go ahead and put a comment in the comment section of Facebook Live, letting us know where you're worshiping from. Our opening hymn is on page 3 of your service bulletin. Please stand as you're able for the cross. Blessed be the one holy and living God.
Glory to God forever and ever.
Beloved God, as we approach your presence, guide and stir us with your Holy Spirit, that we may become one body, one spirit, in Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you have knit together your elect in one communion and fellowship in the mystical body of your Son, Christ our Lord. Give us grace so to follow your blessed saints in all virtuous and godly living, that we may come to those ineffable joys that you have prepared for those who truly love you, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God in glory everlasting. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the Revelation to John. After this I, John, looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God who is seated on the throne and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. And they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, singing, "Amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these, robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one who knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to spirits of the water of life. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Taste and see. A reading from the first letter of John. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we're God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. And after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
Please be seated. Today we have something a little different. In fact, I think in the 8 or 9 years that I've been here, we've never had a screen up here before. But yesterday, as you might have read on the sidebar of page 8, yesterday was our diocesan convention. That's our annual meeting of the diocese. Our diocese goes from Palo Alto down to here. In that annual meeting, the bishop shared her annual address with us, and she's asked that each of the parishes share that, and that's what we're going to do today.
Good morning, and welcome to the 43rd Convention of the Episcopal Diocese of El Camino Real. It is with joy that we reflect together on the year that has passed since our last convention, and that same joy calls us to step forth into what God has in store for us in the years to come. I want to remind us that our diocese sits on the rich soil that was the ancestral lands farmed and roamed and the waters fished by the Esalen, Costanoan, Olof, Salinan, Yokuts, and Chumash peoples, among others about whom little or nothing is known. These lands have throughout generations also welcomed many people from different cultures and places all over the globe, including people from what is now Latin America, Asia, the Middle East, Europe, and parts east in our country. As a diocese, we are a people enriched by our shared heritage, saddened by failing to love each other as neighbors, and repentant of the greed and violence we have done and still do to each other. We are a work in progress, and our ministries are ever evolving as we strive to be the church that God calls us to be. Surrounding this work and watching over us as we engage it are our cloud of witnesses, our saints. Some of these souls go far back in history. Others are more recent, as read in our necrology of this convention, when we honor the people who have gone from our communities this year. I have here with me a picture of my grandmother, a stalwart pillar of the church, the person my grandfather suffered to remind us always delayed leaving the church. She had to be the last one so that she could turn out the lights. At her memorial service, I stayed behind to turn out the lights, knowing that the very next day, someone else would take on that simple task. I'm reminded of her dedication and faithfulness every day. You also have beloved people to honor who led with wisdom in their time and place. These souls provided the foundation on which we stand. Many of them knew that they were builders of a future, and they would not see the finished product of their labors. So it is with our work. As a reflection attributed to Oscar Romero reminds us, we are prophets of a future, not our own. To that end, you and I faithfully work to build God's kingdom, living into our baptismal covenant, proclaiming the good news, working for justice and peace, and respecting the dignity of every human being. Recently, the Visioning Task Force and I conducted 6 sessions called Glimpses of God's Dream. We listened throughout our diocese, both in person and online, and heard your hopes and dreams, what you believe God may be up to in our diocese. You did not disappoint, for we are more interested in serving others than in self-preservation. We care more about connection than conformity. Together, we understand the value of what we have, and we are thoughtful about what it takes to live into what we glimpse as God's dream in our place here in God's kingdom. Last year, our West Coast Collaborative, which is our school for ministry, completed its first year of a lay preaching course. Now we are toward the second year offering that same preaching year formation program for deacons. Each year, we add a layer to this foundation that develops the leadership of the church we are becoming. Along with that, we now have added another community trailblazer to our diocese. The Reverend Jen Compton and the Reverend Deacon Joel Martinez serve in very different congregations and towns in our diocese, leading people out of the church buildings and stepping into their communities in order to discover new ways to engage and be challenged. The work of our trailblazers is brave and hopeful, and their willingness to patiently find companions to embark on this discovery with them is what will shape our future and keep us nimble. These two initiatives, the West Coast Collaborative and the Community Trailblazer, are essential to the church that God calls into being. And God's people strive to discern what the church is to be in every generation. The Church of Thomas Aquinas did not look the same as the Church of Queen Elizabeth I, nor of John Wesley. The Church of Bishop Ingram Kitt is not the same as the Church of my grandmother, nor is this the church that we have now. How society views church and institutions in general, and how we have led in essential ways in the formation of our leaders, and led us to a shortage of ordained clergy in all denominations, and ours is no exception. Here in our diocese, we currently have 13 congregations in transition, with only a few offering full-time priest positions. And other dioceses around us have even more vacancies. Canon Marco works very hard with congregations to persuade them to do the essential work of transition, and even in the best of times, change isn't easy. We need to adjust our expectations, as the one priest, one parish model is fading fast. Yet, with all of this comes opportunity. The extensive training of our lay leaders and the adoption of new models for clergy parish partnerships. Now, these opportunities before us are not new ones. They just arrived here a bit later than they have in other places in the West. So, yes, we have challenges, and we are also delighted in new ways of being together and connecting with each other. One of the highlights of this year was the first in-person spring renewal that we held in April. Then we engaged in deep conversation about our baptismal covenant and our personal pilgrim journeys. And the joy of sharing in food and fellowship and fun was palpable. It was a moment, though, that will remain imprinted on me. At the end of the Eucharist, with the rhythmic music, we began to dance. It was a stunning moment that I hoped would never end, for like David, we freely danced before the Lord. Our next spring renewal will be this coming May, the 17th and the 18th, and our keynote will be the Right Reverend Michael Hun, Bishop of the Diocese of the Rio Grande. Bishop Hun, you probably know, is the former canon to the ordinary for our presiding Bishop Michael Curry. And Bishop Hun will talk with us about our theme, Stepping Out with Soul, a theme that arose from our experience at our spring renewal and the shared dance that last day. Another dance that had a profound effect on me was a brief time that I spent at the installation of the bishop in Nauvoland this past May. One evening there was a dinner, and then the floor was cleared for dancing. While usually, in my experience, indigenous peoples dance and the rest of us watch, because we don't know what it means, or perhaps we are embarrassed about our own missteps. In this case, however, the dance was very simple, and we were all invited, not only invited, but expected to join in. We gently made our way, moving with our partners side by side in a shuffle, almost like a walk with a spring in our step. Unlike the unbridled whirling of our spring renewal, this was a community expression of a sorrowful past and hope for a shared future. As I danced, I reflected on the invitation that was before us, offered yet unspoken. So cautiously I stepped in the very next day, asking the bishop for an ongoing conversation. Curious about what a shared future might look like, the Bishop of Valpolent and I have arranged for 6 people from our diocese to travel with me to Valpolent this coming week. In imitation of the dance I just described, we want to walk together to learn from each other and discover what our relationship could become. We will learn about the blessing way of the Dine and the Episcopal Church's history in that place. Please pray for us that we will have open minds and hearts and that we will listen much more than we talk. Help us to be faithful and hear the invitation that is extended. Stepping out with soul, our theme for this coming year is an ongoing invitation to dance in many different ways before the Lord. Surrounded by those who have stepped out ahead of us, we may swirl or we may shuffle as you and I connect with the joys and sorrows of our history, with the thoughtful reflection of our present, so that we move into a future that is both authentic and faithful. As faithful pilgrims, we remember that ours is the way of love and peace, and that the legacy we leave depends on the steps we take every day. How we act, how we speak, shapes the future for those who will be welcomed after us in this rich place that we call the Diocese of El Camino Real. As faithful followers of Jesus, we are prophets of a future not our own.
I think I only have 3 observations about that. The first is, I'm amazed I could run all of that just off my phone. I just think that's wonderful. Secondly, we had a screen in worship and the ceiling didn't fall. The third thing that I want to share is 2 of the 6 people that are going to be going to Navajo land early tomorrow morning are Jeff and myself. So we're going to be gone from tomorrow morning till Friday night, going around the Navajo Nation and the Episcopal churches that are there, and as the bishop said, listening more than talking. You will get to hear all about it when we return.
Please stand as you're able. And let us affirm the faith of our church through the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God,
the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down. who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
As we pray for the church in our world, if you are joining us on Facebook Live, please put your own thanksgivings and intercessions in the comments section. With all our heart and with all our mind, let us pray to the Lord, saying, we thank you, Lord.
Let us give thanks to God our Father for all his gifts so freely bestowed upon us, for the beauty and wonder of our creation in earth and sky and sea, for all that is gracious in the lives of men and women, revealing the image of Christ.
We thank you, Lord.
For the diverse and vibrant Native communities who make their home here and across these lands, for all Native peoples on whose ancestral homelands we are worshiping this morning.
We thank you, Lord.
For our daily food and drink, our homes and families and our friends,
we thank you, Lord.
For minds to think and hearts to love and hands to serve,
we thank you, Lord.
For health and strength to work and leisure to rest and play,
we thank you, Lord.
For the brave and courageous who are patient in suffering and faithful in adversity,
we thank you, Lord.
For the faith of the church in Jerusalem, for relief and comfort for the victims of wars in Ukraine, Gaza, and Israel, and for a peaceful end to all wars,
we thank you, Lord.
For all valiant seekers after truth, liberty, and justice,
we thank you, Lord.
For the communion of saints in all times and places,
we thank you, Lord.
We continue to pray for those in our own community, Marilyn, Jim, Shirley, Linda, Chantel, Mary Gay Ross, Brandon McRoberts, Hunter and parents, Kevin Baker, Ernie, Dan and Carl, the people of Gaza and Israel, the people of Ukraine and Russia, Terry Bond, Ritikar the Calzada and family, Delphine and Kendra. We pray for those who have died, especially Linda Rombo, Matthew Perry, Herbert Birdie Bauman, and Patricia Kane Totten. We pray for the diocesan visit of Navajo land, for Carol, Tony, Ken Mattingly, Dr. Wanda Poltavosky, Mary Durkic, baby Teresa, Kai, and from home, above all, we give you thanks for the great mercies and promises given to us in Jesus Christ, our Lord.
To him be praise and glory for you, O Father, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Hasten, O Father, the coming of your kingdom, and grant that we, your servants, who now live by faith, may with joy behold your Son at his coming in glorious majesty, even Jesus Christ, our only mediator and advocate. Amen. And now let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness. And by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace. Let us share peace with one another. Peace. And if you're on Facebook Live, go ahead and put the word peace or some other appropriate word in the comment section of Facebook Live. Also, if you're on Facebook Live and you have a birthday, anniversary, or other celebration, put that into the comments section as well. Please be seated for the announcements. In these last 5 weeks of the season after Pentecost, we have changed up our liturgy. We had some new service music that is new to some of us, and we will grow to love over the next couple weeks. So just wanted to call your attention to that new music and liturgy that we have in here. We also have two new people that are serving in worship today. Gertie, is this your first time serving as Eucharistic minister? Welcome to the altar. And Blake Diaz is singing with us in the bass section over in the choir, so welcome, Blake. We have a couple things on page 2 under the notable events to call to your attention. First of all, we have a newcomers brunch next Sunday at 11:30 in the forum room. So if you've arrived in the last year or so and have not been to a newcomers brunch, please do join us at 11:30. You can meet other newcomers. You'll get to know me a little bit better and some of our vestry members as well. Do let me know if you think you're going to be able to attend the lunch so that we can get the right amount of food. Then on Wednesday, the 22nd of November, we have a Thanksgiving Eve service in this space at 7 p.m. in the evening. So Thanksgiving Eve service is coming up as well. We've got photos that are over here of our dearly departed. Some of you have brought those in. My dad is over there. Jeff's parents are over there. We would ask that you take the photos home next week after worship so that we can appreciate them for another Sunday. But we do want to bless those photos and those people that are over right there right now.
Rob,
yes?
Don't forget the tree.
Okay, we'll do that at the offering. So we've got over here, and actually we'll bless the tree as well, so thank you. So you may have written a name on the tree that's in the back that Jane has put together. Thank you, Jane. Or you may have brought a photo. Would you raise your dominant hand as we bless all of those who have gone before? God, we ask your blessing on those we love, especially those we love that have died. They are dear to us, and we know they are dear to you as well. In particular, God, we lift up those photos that are here with us and those names that are written on the tree. They are dear to us, and again, they are dear to you. We know they continue in ways that we can scarcely imagine, but we miss them, and someday we will all join them. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we ask your blessing. Amen. And in particular today in our own community, we want to remember Barbara Ormsby, Denny Ward, the Reverend Norman Soames, and Henry Brazil. We commend them to God. One of the things that we're going to do in just a moment is our ingathering of pledge cards. And if you've been here in years past, you know that you'll get up from the pew and you will walk up and place your pledge card on the altar. Is there anyone that needs a blank pledge card and envelope? We have extras in the narthex that we can get to you. Anyone need one? Grab one back there. David, if you want to grab some so that people can get them from you, those are available. Do we have any birthdays, anniversaries, or other celebrations today? We've got a couple listed birthdays listed on the bulletin. Maya and Emily, who I believe are both granddaughters for Shirley Holgate, have birthdays. And then Lorelei has a fifth birthday coming up. Hi, Lorelei. Any other birthdays, anniversaries, or celebrations? Stormy? Tawny's birthday, very good. Yes, Brian.
My birthday.
Happy birthday, Brian.
And same day, but about the same year.
Okay. Funny how that happens. Any other celebrations in here? Yes. Jerry? Happy birthday, Jerry. Another year. Very nice. Corey, anything to celebrate from Facebook Live?
Happy birthday to Peter's Ajax grandson, Dan.
Great, thank you. We have a birthday prayer there on toward the bottom of page 11, and we'll say this birthday prayer together. Praying, gracious God, who made us in your own image, we thank you for life, love, and joy. Send your blessing upon these, your children, who have completed another year. Surround them with your grace, fill them with your love, and strengthen them to be your servants in the world. This we ask through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And on the top of the next page, we have a prayer for travelers. So we'll pray for us who are traveling to Navajo land and anyone else traveling. O God, our Heavenly Father, whose glory fills the whole creation and whose presence we find wherever we go, preserve those who travel. Surround them with your loving care, protect them from every danger, and bring them in safety to their journey's end. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Congratulations to all who are celebrating. And now walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us an offering and sacrifice to God. And I invite you to come up and place your pledge cards on the altar. And please don't trip over the cord. I know that some of you have already dropped off or mailed in your pledge card, and you're certainly welcome to do that over the next couple weeks as well.
Oh,
Eucharistic Prayer C from our Book of Common Prayer is on page 13 of your bulletin or on your screen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
God of all power, ruler of the universe, you are worthy of glory and praise.
Glory to you forever and ever.
At your command, all things came to be. The vast expanse of interstellar space, galaxies, suns, the planets in their courses, and this fragile earth, our island home.
By your will they were created and have their being.
From the primal elements you brought forth the human race and blessed us with memory, reason, and skill. You made us the rulers of creation. But we turned against you and betrayed your trust, and we turned against one another.
Have mercy, Lord, for we are sinners in your sight.
Again and again you called us to return. Through prophets and sages, you revealed your righteous law. And in the fullness of time, you sent your only son, born of a woman, to fulfill your law, to open for us the way of freedom and peace.
By his blood, he reconciled us. By his wounds, we are healed.
And therefore, we praise you, joining with the heavenly chorus, with prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and with all those in every generation who have looked to you in hope, to proclaim with them your glory in their unending hymn. So, Father, we who have been redeemed by him and made a new people by water and the Spirit, now bring before you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his friends and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, gave thanks, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering now his work of redemption, in offering to you this sacrifice of thanksgiving, we celebrate his death and resurrection as we await the day of his coming. Lord God of our fathers and mothers, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, God of Sarah, Rebecca, Leah, and Rachel, God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, open our eyes to see your hand at work in the world about us. Deliver us from the presumption of coming to this table for solace only and not for strength, for pardon only and not for renewal. Let the grace of this holy communion make us one body, one spirit in Christ, that we may worthily serve the world in his name.
Risen Lord,
be known to us in the breaking of the bread. Accept these prayers and praises, Father, through Jesus Christ, our great high priest, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit your church gives honor, glory, and worship from generation to generation.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God, all are welcomed at God's table.
Thank you.
Post-communion prayer or prayer of thanksgiving is on page 19 of your service bulletin. Please stand as you're able. Let us pray. Loving God, we give you thanks for restoring us in your image and nourishing us with spiritual food in the sacrament of Christ's body and blood. Now send us forth a people forgiven, healed, renewed, that we may proclaim your love to the world and continue in the risen life of Christ our Savior. Amen. God's blessing be with you. Christ's peace be with you. The Spirit's outpouring be with you, now and always. Amen.
Thank you.
stepping out with the soul of faith and hope into what God has in store for us, let us go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.